14. Two discernments were made in the corporeal body. In the first discernment, one feels one's soul as a unique organ and does not understand that this is the whole of Israel. In the second discernment, the true light of the soul of Israel does not shine on him in all its power of illumination, but only partially by the measure he has purified himself by returning to the collective. And the sign for the body's complete correction is when one feels that one's soul exists in the whole of Israel, in each and every one of them, for which he does not feel himself as an individual. For one depends on the other. At that time, he is complete, flawless, and the soul truly shines on him in its fullest power, as it appeared in Adam HaRishon.
Yeah. So, Baal Salam writes that in the corporeal body, two discernments were made. First discernment is when he feels his soul as a specific item and does not understand that it's a whole, the whole soul. He feels alone. And the rest, and the others are others. In other words, he still doesn't have a real perception. A real perception, which we don't understand, is like in Einstein's theory. We don't understand it, although we talk about it. Here too, with respect to the soul, we don't understand how much our perception, because we're in the will to receive, it's called a perception of the imaginary world. It seems to us like there are billions of people, still vegetative, animate, all kinds of things like that. We see all that in our broken will to receive. And that's why they seem to us like many people, many animals, many, many. But in truth, when we begin to correct, we begin to connect. That's what he says, that he feels his soul as a unique organ and doesn't understand that this is the whole, the common soul. But when he corrects himself, he comes to a state, as it is written, as one man with one heart, that there aren't many, there are no parts. It was only divided according to our intellect, our mind, which was spoiled, which was broken, corrupted. But when the mind begins to connect into one desire, one goal, one source that brings him, it's one light. The closer we get to the light of Yechidah, from the word Yechid, one, unique, then we begin to attain more and more that there aren't many people here. There's no plural here, not many, but all of that appears to us in our intellect, in our perception, as many parts, pieces, still vegetative, animate, and speaking. And in each one, we have many discernments, but there's no such thing. It all connects into one. So, the first discernment is when he feels his soul as a unique organ and doesn't understand that this is only how it seems to him, a part of the common soul. The second discernment, the true light of the soul of Israel does not shine on him in all its power of illumination, but only partially by the measure he has purified himself by returning to the collective, meaning to the extent that he approaches the collective, to the extent that he connects to others, to that extent he feels more and more that they belong to one system. And the sign that the body has been fully corrected is this, when he feels his soul being in each and every one. That there's no difference. That he is in everyone, everyone is in him, and he really becomes as one. in each of them. And that's why, if he feels himself as an individual, because one depends on the other, at that time he is complete flawless, meaning he doesn't feel the difference between himself and others, and feels everyone as one collective. And the soul truly shines on him in its fullest power, as it appeared in Adam Rishon prior to the breaking.